First of all, I would like to say welcome for everyone. My name is Hakan. I'm working for Mavil Electronic Company. And today's our webinar topic is detection and control equipment used in gaseous fire extinguishing systems. Also, I will talk about the equipments, about products, working principles, project principles, EN54 standards, purpose of usage, and system design. So, what is the detection and control equipment for gas fire extinguishing systems used for? In environments where water extinguishing effect is not sufficient or suitable, extinguishing systems with suitable types of gases are installed. In our country, gas fire extinguishing systems design, material selection and application are made according to EN standards. Okay, let's talk about products. We have ML322 series operates on cross zone principle, has 4 detection zones and 1 extinguishing release output, which is programmable according to site needs. Conventional extinguishing panel is microprocessor controlled, offers high performance and can easily be integrated into all extinguishing projects. Let's talk about a little bit product features. As I said before, it has 4 zones, 1 extinguishing release output. Detection of 2 devices alarming in detection zone, indicating the zone with fire LED. Extinguishing related front panel LEDs and LCD screen provide full information on extinguishing control status. Up to 8 extinguishing status indicator units can be connected to 1 fire extinguishing panel. Programmable first stage sounder output delay we have. Delay can be assigned for detection zones. Adjustable delay and extinguishing times can be adjustable. Non-latching zone option, real-time clock, supervised inputs and outputs, extinguishing release countdown timer, fire and fault LEDs for each detection zone, open short circuit control of input, extinguishing canceling input, extinguishing start input, low pressure input, extinguishing status switch input lines, open and short circuit control for all output lines. Extinguishing mode can be changed remotely via extinguishing status key. The panel can be set to automatic or manual extinguishing modes. Fire and fault relays activate in case of fire and fault. Extinguishing status switch relay, which is activate when the extinguishing status switch is set to manual only. Hold relay that is activate when the countdown is held while the extinguishing process is activate. Dry contact relay output for fire and fault. Energy for or voltage free change over contact option for outputs. Possibility to work with 8 input and 8 output with extension cards, 7 8 ways IO modules, 8 input, 8 output, I/O module cards, ability to choose cross zone working with computer software as activate or passive, as active or passive, storing event logs up to 1000 events. Event records can be viewed with computer software, which we called X-Manager software. Event logs can be viewed with X-Manager software. Printing of event logs stored in memory via computer, printer, or via RS-232 port. The desired zone can be assigned as extinguishing zone. Detection zones can be displayed and tested. Zones can be set to disable and test modes. First and second stage relay outputs, gas extraction output, and extinguishing release button can be disabled. Programmable delay and extinguishing time. Panel indicators and control can be moved via optional extinguishing status indicator. Updating software to main card of panel and input outputs of expansion card to assign different functions. Okay, let's talk about our detectors, detector features. Left one is our smoke detector, which it doesn't have any circle on the top of the detector. As you can see on the right side, this is our heat detector. For the heat detector, we have one cycle on the heat detectors. Also, we have multi-sensor detector. If you see two circle on the detector, that means that is a multi-sensor detector. For the smoke detector, smoke detectors have high sensitivity and stability through microprocessor control. Detector utilizes the scattered light sensing principle. If smoke has been the inside of optical chamber, smoke particles inside the chamber collide with transmitter beams and they fall onto the receiver. False alarms are prevented by advanced algorithm before the generated fire signal. Fire detectors are suitable for indoor use. Conventional heat detectors have high sensitivity and stability through microprocessor control. Heat control detector detects temperature change by temperature sensitive thermistor. When the ambient temperature reaches 60 degrees or there is a temperature increase specified in EN54 standard, this detected analog value is interrupted by the electronical circuits and the fire is detected. False alarms are prevented by advanced algorithm before the generated fire signal. Detectors are suitable for indoor use. Let's talk about our sounders, beacons, sounders, and fire alarm bells. Fire alarm bell is product that can be used by all systems, from intelligent addressable fire alarm systems with MaviGuard and MaxLogic brand to conventional fire alarm systems. It gives an audible output when generating a warning signal in fire alarms, fire alarm panels. Special design for indoor use, compatible with EN54 standards. For the sounder beacons, MaxLogic conventional Sounder and Beacon is an advanced product with autistic design and superior operational performance that is used for visual and audible notifications of fire alarms from panels and provides common use of all systems. From intelligent addressable fire alarm systems to conventional fire alarm systems, it is powered from conventional sounder line. And let's talk about our buttons. If necessary, an extinguishing release is initiated to initiate the extinguishing by the user. And emergency stop button is designed to wait for the extinguishing if necessary. If there are people working continuously in the location, these buttons should be designed both inside and outside the location. Otherwise, it will be sufficient for the buttons to be at the entrance of the location. And this is the system design. Extinguishing control panel is connected with electronic alarm bell. For the first stage, this is a pre-alarm stage. We are using conventional sounders or conventional sounder beacons. For the second stage, this stage is when the extinguishing process is started, when the tubes are releasing, the second stage sounder is ringing. Also, we have extinguishing output expansion panel, which if you need more extinguishing output, you can use this one to expand your output up to 8 output. Also, you should connect the detectors for the first zone and for the second zone. These are alarm zones. The panel is waiting, for example, it is working for the cross zone detection principle. If the heat detector, for example, this detector detects a fire alarm signal, it is waiting the other detector to give another alarm from different zone. If this one gives an alarm which is the same zone, the extinguishing process will not start. But if the smoke detector detects an alarm which is in different zone, it is starting the extinguishing process. Most of the panels are working cross zone principle because the extinguishing tubes are expensive materials. We don't want to release them immediately. We need to be sure that there is a real fire, and then you can release the tubes. Also, if you mentioned that that's a false alarm and you don't want to start extinguishing process, you want to stop it, you can press the extinguishing emergency stop button. Or if some accident happened and detectors didn't detect the signal, you can press the extinguishing manual release button. It will start the extinguishing process immediately. Also, you can use 8-way input-output I/O module, which is the relays for the input and outputs. You can use the extinguishing status indicator unit with extinguishing status switch and releasing button. You can think like this is like a repeater panel. It is showing the status of the system from different place. You can use it if you need for the another area. And you should use network module for this connection. Okay, let's talk about extinguishing system working principle. First of all, the priorities of fire effects, for example, smoke, temperature, flame, or are determined in the location where the gas extinguishing system will be designed. Cross-zone detection is done at least two detector in each zone, and the detector type of each zone must be different, such as smoke and temperature. If there is an suspended ceiling, raised floor, cabin or cabinets in the area, separate detection should be made in each section. As you can see in the animation, if the fire is detected in this area, there is four detector in for this area, and all detectors are in fire alarm process. Then, as you know, the black line, also the red line, is in fire. Then it is starting the extinguishing process. If only the red line is sending a signal, that will not start the extinguishing process. Okay, let's talk about project principles and EN54 standards. Let's talk about manual call points, alarm buttons. Alarm buttons should be placed on escape roads, all doors inside and outside of the escape stairs, as exit stairs, and all exits that open the open air, fresh air. They can also be placed next to special hazards and or firefighting equipment. Other devices and systems, in addition to the main purpose detection and alarm signals from the system, can be used to trigger auxiliary devices directly or indirectly, such as fire extinguishing equipment, smoke or fire doors, smoke ventilation equipment, smoke or fire dampers, closing the ventilation, elevator control, and safety doors. Operation or malfunction of auxiliary device should not compromise the operation of the fire detection system or prevent it from signaling other auxiliary devices. Operation of other fire protection systems. In general, the fire detection and alarm system can be used to provide start signals to other fire protection systems, such as automatic fire extinguishing systems, smoke and heat control systems, systems that trigger the release and closing the fire doors, sound evacuation system. Okay, then let's talk about integration to fire detection system. Gas extinguishing system alarm and fault outputs. If a gas extinguishing system is installed in a building, if there is a detection and warning system in the building, the alarm and fault outputs of the extinguishing system are connected to the fire alarm system and monitor with separate zonal indicators. It is connected to fire detection systems with fire and fault relays on extinguishing systems and can be monitored as a separate zone. Thank you for your participation. If you have any question, you can send an email to export@mavili.com.tr. Also, please follow us from Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube with Mavili Electronic Global account. Also, if you have any question, you can write on the chat menu, which is in the left side of the screen. I will wait for your questions. Okay, if you don't have any question, thank you for your participation. We will wait you for the next webinar next week, same day and same time. Have a nice day.